Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Yes, another really big and powerful switch mode power supply. This one is a Glassman Europe Limited. It's called LV80-37 and DC power supply. It's a variable DC power supply and it can give from 0 to 80 volts all the way to 37 amps, and yes, it can do both at the same time. So that is 3000 watts of output power constantly. Okay, so this is a very, very big and mean power supply. 2-unit height, full depth. It is really, really heavy as well. I don't know if you recognize this layout. Now look at this picture here. As you see on this picture, Sorensen DCS 80-37, or the DCS series from Sorensen, this is exactly the same layout. And that is, I think, Glassman Sorensen, they joined forces back in the 80s or 90s, or when they did it. I can't actually find information about that. But this is exactly the same power supply, both inside and outside. Let's look at the Sorensen specifications. So let's scroll down to the 3000... what models exactly. Here we go, and it's almost the last one in the series, so the 3000 watt series. So yeah. Oh, that is really something. I think it's very impressive with the specification for ripple and noise and all that kind of stuff here. So definitely a very interesting power supply. If we look at the rear, we'll see that I modified the mains input for IEC one phase connector. The original mains input is a three phase connector. If you look at the picture I put in here, you will see it's a very big and nasty three phase input. And But I don't have a three-phase power here in my lab, and I really don't need that many thousands of watts. So it's perfectly okay to run this off a single phase. Look at the specifications here on the input connector. 5200 VA three-phase input. Hoi, oi, oi, that is something, isn't it? When I got this one, this connector was missing, so I had to figure out how to wire the different pins together for local control of a voltage and current. So this is why I filmed this from all sorts of angles, so you'll be able to see what I've done here. Maybe I can find documentation for this and input here if I am lucky. The power output is inside a cage. Oh, I need to go and get a screwdriver, then you can see how they did this. So here is how it's done. Plenty of room to go and work with all sorts of wrenches. You can add some really big, heavy-duty cables to the output. Here you can see this is indeed the 80 volt 37 amp version. And it also says here, be careful, this one can give you more than 42 volts. So you are in high power world of big bad stuff here. I marked the top one here with red, so it's easy to see this is the positive. It really wasn't that easy to see before I marked that one, so go figure why they didn't mark this really, really nice and clear here. See, can't see any really easy to see markings, can you? I don't know. I really don't see anything. It's only because I marked it. That is also a little bit crazy. So how about we boot this up? Because I kind of know this one works, so it's not going to be that fascinating. But let's just see this in operation. You got to hear this. Embarrassment. Okay. 40 watts of idle. That is how it is. Then we can crank up the voltage, okay? Super nice. I think it is, you push, is it this one? Yeah. So when you push and hold this one, you can see the amps. And if you push and hold this one, what can you see here? I don't know what you can see. Not a lot. Low voltage protection. Let's do it again. Yes, that is 40 watts. No, now it's 30 watts of idle. But that's 50 watts. Oh my god. 60. 70. You see? And this is a classic Sorensen power supply design. The entire DCS series, they do this. The idle current is just, or idle power is just super, super high. So at 80 volts of output, the idle power is 97 watts. So we see some burning hot snooper resistors in here. But this is how they generate nice and clean output. And that is important, of course it is. Let's try and load this with a little bit of watts. Let me try and play here a little bit. So let's try and load it a little bit. This is about 200 watts, isn't it? I just connected two of my loads, and I believe this is as close as I can be to 200 watts. And input power is 303, right? So that is 66%. Let's look a little bit inside this fantastic power supply. Here is my little single phase modification. Maybe we should just pull this out when we are playing around. As you can see, there's an extra screw down there for three phase input. So the first one is, of course, ground chassis earth connection, but the other three, that's the three phases. Three phase filter, three capacitors, another three phase filter, three capacitors, then the three, so you can actually see it here, right? And they go to a mains switch, which is also an auto fuse, 20 amp. Hoi, hoi, hoi. And then from the fuse, it goes to the rectifier. And I believe there is another screw down here. Or another terminal. Yes, it is. Down here. Let me see if you can see that. Yes, you can actually. Oh, there you go. Here you go, here you go. Can you see it? That one is the third phase for the rectifiers. So there's a big nasty rectifier down there somewhere, and the charge capacitors for the DC And then there is a DC fuse of also 20 amps. And now I don't dare to point with my fingers anymore. So the big, powerful DC, I think it actually goes straight to this board. And this is the drive board, the power drive board, right? And then here is the power. Rectifiers. Nasty stuff, huh? And the inductor. And then we go out. Output filter. And current measurements and all that kind of stuff. We got some op amps here for voltage and current monitoring. And this goes, of course, to the regulation board that is under the IEEE board, because this has also got an IEEE board. So it's fully equipped, this one. IEEE, funny stuff. And the other card down there, that's just tons of op amps and all that kind of analog stuff. Oh yeah, here we go. It is actually possible to see the full bridge primary side. If you look carefully, I think, yes, you can see this. So that will be the trigger transformer for the gates. We probably also got some diodes sitting here. All sorts of resistors and good stuff for heating up. How about we power this up and monitor what's going on when it's running in idle at different voltages? Then you'll see what I'm talking about. The snubber circuits, and probably also there will be some discharge. Yes, here we go. Discharge resistor for the capacitors. I expect those gonna shine a lot. Yes, we got a lot of big bad things. So let's play a little bit with the thermal camera. Let's see, here is the primary side, and down here, remember, discharge and probably also balance resistors or something like that, right? Yeah, no surprise, they're running at 120 Celsius, so that is quite hot. But obviously, resistors can do that, but I need to be careful where I put my fingers now, otherwise it's gonna be a really, really short video. So that will be primary side snubbers. Okay, here we go. 83 Celsius for that one. And you see, there's a capacitor in series with this resistor. Also, a good idea to check, is this capacitor running really warm? Because that is a very nice thing to check for and fix. And over here. Oi, I was too close for that one. So that's also primary side snubbers. You see that because you see some capacitors and then the resistors. Let's look at the secondary side, the diodes. We are only running at 24, are we? Yeah, 24 volts output. So this is almost nothing. So that means that we're looking at the secondary side snubber. That one. See? Almost 100. Oh, I need to clean the screen for dust. Is that better? Ooh, huh? That was dirty. And we got that one. Why is that so warm? You also get a, got a very warm capacitor here. I need to log a little bit of that, because hot capacitors is like always a very, very bad idea. Oh, those capacitors, see? They got no resistor in series with them, and they're directly connected to output positive. Isn't that the output positive goes right here? Look, there's an isolation thingy, right? So that means it's chassis. And down here as well, direct connection to something. No resistor on that, I guess. Yeah, because it's this little brown capacitor. That is the snubber. That lamp is just annoying. Yeah. This is probably not a whole lot. But definitely I want to look a little bit into this. Got two fans here, and one fan is cooling the transformer and the inductor, and the other one goes straight through the tunnel, the cooling tunnel. And this is a classic Sorensen DCS board. This is used in the more or less all their power supplies, and it looks exactly the same with the pot meter and the digital volt and amp meter. They're using the same ICs as you can see here. So all that is absolutely normal. I really, really like this power supply, by the way, I must say. The power supply is from 1997, and I tested this and I fixed this back in 21, so I added a little note here for myself, for the future me. Let's do one more little experiment. I cranked the output up to its maximum, just to see what is this lamp on. I kind of didn't ask for that, did I? Let's see. Ooh, where can I put my fingers here? So that is the primary side snubber, but now it's running at much higher duty cycle because it's generating maximum output voltage. So I expect the snubber here to be, where the heck is it? So yeah, I'm looking, and that is the output load resistor, that one. So that's what we're looking at here. Yes, let's put on the macro. And it's much more nice and sharp. There will be. It's impossible to video this because I really can't touch anything here. I think it's very important to have high respect for stuff like this where you put your fingers. Oy. Yeah, I better turn this off, crank down the voltage. It is not designed to run without the lid on. And you can imagine all the airflow needs to go through all those resistors, right? So I better turn this off. Thank you very much for watching, and see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.